Countdown is on. We're now less than 2 months until a total solar eclipse turns day into night.
Yeah, and you know, experts say now is the time to get ready for the greatest show in the universe, literally. WLWT News 5 meteorologist Adam Berniston is sitting down with our local astronomer, Dean Regas, to get us all of the details. Hi, guys.
Yeah, hey, Ashley and Cherie. Thanks so much, and thank you, Dean, for joining us. This is a big event, obviously. A lot of questions here people are probably wondering. But first off, what should people expect when the solar eclipse comes around in April?
All right, I don't want to overhype this because I can't. It is the most incredible thing that's going to happen. The day will turn to night. The sun will be blocked out completely. And it's such a rare thing to happen around here. I want people to get really excited about this because it is incredible. The whole experience of the sky turning a weird color, the stars coming out in the middle of the daytime, the temperature dropping, the animals going crazy, and then, of course, the people going crazy, too. It's an amazing event.
And where should people kind of go to get the best view or to see what should people, how could people see this event coming up?
This is the tricky part because in Cincinnati, it's going to be 99% eclipsed, which sounds awesome, but that one little percent that's not blocked is still going to, you know, make it not as good. So everybody, I want people to get out of the city that day. And best places are just across the border in Indiana. If you go out I-74, just about 45 minutes to an hour, or go up north on I-75 towards Dayton, that's a good place to go too. But the path of totality goes all the way from Texas all the way up to Maine. So there's a lot of places to go and choose from. So, you know, watch the weather and see how that looks too.
Yeah, weather, big factor. As far as our region, kind of what's the timeline for when we're expected to see the totality hit our region and to see even the partial eclipse occurring?
Yeah, the partial stages, I always like that too. When you first see the moon just starting to take a little bite out of the sun, that starts about 1:52 in the afternoon in Cincinnati. The maximum eclipse will be about 3:09. So just a little after 3 o'clock, that's where you'll get that 99% in Cincinnati. And then it varies depending on where you're on the path, but somewhere around 3:09 is about right for around this area too.
And the solar eclipse, obviously amazing to see, but it has some dangers as far as the sun's rays. Obviously you don't want to look at it. What are some safe ways and some viewing tips that people should be aware of?
I mean, I always hear my mom's voice in my head, don't stare at the sun because it will damage your eyes. Absolutely. So even if a little sliver of sunlight is showing, you have to get those special glasses, the protective glasses that you put over your eyes to be able to see the sun safely. And so it's really a good idea to get them now because they'll probably be in short supply when we get closer to April 8th. But there's lots of good ways to do some viewing of this safely, and you don't necessarily need a telescope for this. It's really a good thing to take in just with the naked eye, well, with the glasses, of course.
Right. And this event, we've seen it in other parts of the country before, years past, but how rare is it to see totality come over this close to our region?
Yeah, I mean, this the last total solar eclipse in Cincinnati was the year 1395. And the next one will be the year 3046. That's pretty darn rare.
Right.
So this is about as close as it's going to get to us in our lifetime. Just the precision of this is so cool, to down to the exact second when you can see this. I'm already like in the zone. This is going to be so cool.
Amazing. Well, Dean, thank you so much. I'm sure we both could talk about this forever because I love space, love the eclipse coming up here. But this is all the time we have for now. I'm sure we'll have much more coverage. You can get in touch with Dean and learn more about the eclipse at astrodean.com. You can also check out his podcast, Looking Up. I'll send it back to you, Cherie and Ashley.
Adam, thanks so much. Dean has suddenly gotten me excited about this. I'm singing Bonnie Tyler's Total Eclipse of the Heart in my head right now. All right, so our eclipse coverage continues throughout the night for you. We've been doing this all day. We're getting you ready for this, again, historic event 46 days in advance. You can scan the QR code on your screen for a full eclipse guide. We're going to have much more tonight on WLWT News 5 and, again, on our website, always WLWT.com.